BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Marston. Unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music.
It's time for our first bit of live music then tonight. Welcome to Ledbury's Market Theatre.
Now, Jake Gamble is a musician who recently uploaded his music to bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing. He lives on the outskirts of Hereford. He's influenced by some very diverse musical greats: Stevie Wonder, Alex Turner, Otis Redding, and Kanye West. Ladies and gentlemen, Jake Gamble!
Yoichi! Right, guys, I'm Jake Gamble. I hope you enjoy this stuff. Someone, it's called It's What We Do For Love. All the fans in the back, thanks for coming. This is Flying High. Butterflies go flying round my stomach when I'm catching your eyes. I got feelings, not in you, girl. Can't you see it's you that I'm trying to seduce? Now I'm trying to impress you. No, girl, you look so sexy when you're wearing that dress. I wanna be close, closer to you. I'm waiting for the right time to make my moves, yeah. 'Cause I'm flying high in life, I'm flying high in life. I don't know which way to go, but I know in the end I'll get you. It's so I'm racing against time. Don't wanna miss the chance to make you mine. I can see in your eyes the way you feel for me is in disguise. So I move in from the side, I gently soak your hand, look deep in your eyes, then I lean towards your lips. I got my eyes closed, heading for that perfect kiss, yeah. 'Cause I'm flying high in life, I'm flying high in life, girl, I'm flying high in life, I'm flying high in life. And I don't know which way I went, but I know in the end I got you. Look back into the past, I think how did time pass and go so fast. You and I side by side, and it could be this way until we die. 'Cause I'm flying high in life, I'm flying high in life, girl, I'm flying high in life, I'm flying high in life. 'Cause I'm flying high in life, I'm flying.
That's flying high in life.
See our session snaps right now.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
So here we are then. It's the day after the night before. I'm in our Hereford studio with Jake Gamble. How do you think it went?
It went really well. I really enjoyed myself yesterday.
You've had the rare thing where you've had a chance to already hear the crowd's reaction to what they made of your performance.
I wasn't expecting that feedback, but it gives you like the edge to carry on, more confident on stage and stuff.
I've been looking at your Facebook today. I see that you went to Elson School in Hereford. You went to Hereford Sixth Form College, which is where you are at the moment, doing the odd bit of work at Point Four. But that's not a Herefordshire accent.
No, it's not. It's in the house. It's the family.
So what's your ultimate aim with your music?
Just get regular gigs. I just like the feeling, like the nerves before.
You've got some good fans there. A lot of people turned up yesterday.
Yeah. I want to say a big thank you to my fans that showed up yesterday. All my friends, a couple of family members came down from Liverpool.
Yeah, because I haven't really seen your name on any flyers up till this point. So no. You've only just obviously uploaded your tracks to us guys here.
Done a lot of gigs, but in like pubs, people's weddings, doing covers. Went down to London a couple of months ago. A mate called me down there to do a gig in London, which was really good support. And like two huge bands in London. I want to go out as just Jake Gamble.
Having now heard the music that you're producing, I can't quite put my finger on what sort of covers you would do.
Because I listen to everything. It goes from like 1 minute, like Ray Charles. The next minute I'll be doing Kanye West. You just don't know.
Now you've kind of set that up. I really want to hear what you would do with a Kanye number on an acoustic guitar.
Oh, I think you'd love it.
Really?
Yeah, it's special.
But what sort of Kanye tracks do you do?
I do All of the Lights.
Yeah, oh yeah, okay.
A little riff and then it just takes off. So I go from that to Grenade by Bruno Mars, then go into Eagle Eye Cherry, then go into Ray Charles, and then finish on Jolene by Dolly Parton.
It's really easy just to stand up there and play something like for like, but then to kind of own it and turn it almost into a brand new song.
You do have a bit of fun when you do stuff like that.
Tell me a little bit about college. What are you doing there?
Hereford Sixth Form, doing music technology and English language.
Great little course at Hereford Sixth Form.
Yeah.
I will confess it was the one which I studied as well. And it's just one of those kind of subjects where you're free to do whatever you like and just play about with gadgets or just sit at the piano all day if you want. It's just fantastic.
It is a good fun. I've got a track down which I'm trying to finish off, but it's hard not having one at home. So I'm just going into college using one in my freeze and stuff, trying to like get like little bits in it.
So that's where you do all your recording at the moment, is it?
I did my two-track recording at a Paul Cobbold studio.
Yeah, ex-Rockfield studio, so worked with some great legends there.
Of course, got some experience.
Rockfield was where they recorded Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen, so yeah, it was a real inspiration having you on yesterday. And good luck with the future.
Good, thank you.
And hope all goes well.
Thank you for inviting me.
If you're writing music in Herefordshire and Worcestershire, be part of it. Upload your music to bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
To light my life, the feeling that I feel is right. I got your lighting on my arm, yeah, giving me them eyes that make you charm. And both our faces smiling now, as we face them looking at the clouds. It couldn't be, it couldn't be, it couldn't be any better. Yeah, now we're far away. Two of us thinking I can't get enough of your rosy cheeks and dark brown eyes, their body and their soft small thighs. And girl, you turn my world around, yeah, you're the best thing I ever found. You taught me how to feel, those feelings I never thought were real. It couldn't be, it couldn't be, it couldn't be any better.
Thank you.
You have been a terrific audience.
This is the track I've just finished. It's got a bit of a twist. I've put a bit of twist on this one. I hope you like it. Soak your sheets for all you like, but the magic is not but it come in time. Cause the spitting, there's dissing that's going on in the kitchen. I hate you, but you love me. Standing in your wishing, don't go. No, you shout, don't go. No, no, but I made my mind up and I'm out of here. Can slowly drown your own tears, cause in my eyes I see no fears. In my ears I hear no tears of don't go. No, no, you shout, don't go. But can't you see it's ruined, it's broken, it's on the floor, it's choking. I left it, but you're holding, my back's turned and I'm knowing. It's the memories that are golden, cause the happiness that they're showing. But I see that door is closing, what if you do, it just won't open. Sheets for all you like, but the magic is not gonna come in time.
Thank you. What an amazing voice. Ladies and gentlemen, from Hereford, Jake Gamble.
Listen to hundreds of live gigs.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
Amazing.
Yeah, I thought that was really, really good actually. I've seen him a few times and that was one of the best ones I've ever seen, so that's quality. It's kind of like Dylan meets the Beatles meets Razorlight. It's just a really weird kind of mix, but it's really works really well. Just looked comfortable, looked like he owned it, and just looked like he wanted to be there for a long time. Okay, from everything from rap gigs to pop gigs to festival. I'm a festival kind of guy, so I go to loads of festivals mainly.
I thought it was very, very competent. Very much like Ed Sheeran, very contemporary acoustic.
Absolutely fantastic. It was a brilliant performance. Clear, concise, articulate. It was everything you need from an acoustic performance.
And could you describe what he looked like on stage?
Gorgeous. I go to pretty much lots of cover bands, but some that do their own. It's kind of like indie rock, that kind of stuff.
There's something special about him, to be honest. I think he's got his own sound, but it's in the sort of vein that's out at the moment, the very sort of singular voice with real sort of passion and soul in it. He's charismatic, he's powerful, he's soulful. There's a real soul in his music and in the words that he's singing, and it really comes across. It's quite, some of it's a bit chilling, just sit there and listen to it.
Well, I thought he's absolutely brilliant, outstanding.
Amazing, mate.
Just spot on, real bit indie, just loved it.
Definitely unique, to be honest with you. Unique overall.
Yeah, unique's a good word there. I was lost for words. You just come across confident, come across himself, just doing real well.
Friendly geezer as well, just wanted to impress the crowd. He liked everyone shouting out and just shouting for him. Living the dream.
It's absolutely exceptional. Like, yeah. Like personally, myself, the best on there.
Yeah.
Just his voice.
Top draw. Unique sound.
Really authentic.
He's got his own sound, hasn't he?
Yes, very good. Very interesting. Sorry, more suitable to this small theatre because you could actually hear what he was singing and so on. He's like the archetypal, well, not folk singer because it wasn't folk, but just so serious and engulfed in his music that he was singing and the words that he was saying.
Text 81333 and start your message with HW.
BBC introducing.
Be part of it.
In Hereford and Worcester.